Adrian and I, this is Dr. Subramanian, and this is Dr. I'm going to present the Asian Social Antibiotic Analysis on the 9th of December. I'll be explaining the expected market moves for 9th to 13th of December during this particular webinar, which is going to be held between 5 and 5:30 GMT. So first of all, let me explain to you the expected market moves, which is statistically derived, and now you know that it is the last month of the year 2013, so the players are expected to bring in more and more of related universal moves. So how exactly will come across the weekly moves during this particular time frame? So this week forecast, 9 to 13th of December, and this is the second week. But normally during the second week, every month, we come across the trend in moves to happen, but they will bring it in now the yearly trend reversal. So again, we will come across the moves, groups of moves, and you know, on Friday, they have done the groups of moves after the 9th from April. Even though, as expected, the 9th from April was robust and more than expected, but still, after making a drop quickly as a reaction, then the reaction for the announcement in a matter of only 15-20 minutes, they just rose to the market and slowly turned up during the US session on Friday. And that is mainly, if you notice it, they gained more levels in the case of euro and less level in the case of GBP. And that is mainly in order to handle euro GBP cross. And so, in the sequential trend reversal, they first of all handle the commodity crosses and then later on the commodity cross. Then you come across the end crosses are being handled. Then you find the majors are being handled. And afterwards they handle the European crosses. So now you come across they are handling the majors and the European crosses. And since it is a yearly trend reversal, so they are taking about 2-3 days to do the extreme moves in a specific tab. So what we are seeing on Friday was quick gain in the case of euro GBP and a quick drop in the case of euro CHF and also in the case of GBP CHF. Yeah, also in the case of GBP CHF. So they are handling simultaneously the majors and the beginning of the European crosses, and they are expected to now in this week reverse the majors, and in that they will try to bring in the contrarian move. Then if you look into one of the net changes, you find euro is in positive net change and the USDN is in positive net change as a contrarian move. Euro is in positive net change, but GBP is in negative net change. This is a contrarian move. Euro is positive net change, and USDCHF is positive net change. After making the downward move in the case of EuroCHF, now they tend to make a rise. Then you come across a nominal negative net change in the case of Australian dollar and positive net change in the case of Canadian dollar. That means they are showing the USD gaining move. So when you look into the majors, they are making the USD weakening move, accepting yen, and also USD CHF, but here they are making clear USD gaining move in the case of USD CAD and Australian dollar. So this is how they are trying to bring in the next move of a contrarian move in order to handle the crosses. So now in this week, they are expected to make the slide in the case of euro and GBP and also USDN in order to reverse the yen crosses, and also they will drop more in the case of GBP, and slowly they will make a slide in the case of euro, and later on we will find euro drop more and GBP holding, thereby euro GBP cross will start making the downward move of the way. So you will come across the case of European crosses. Now, euro GBP has almost come to the 84 area from the 82 expect you to make a brief upward stop and then start making the slide above the before they could shift the stops and then start making the slide. In the case of, you know, CHF, they are expected to gain the levels. And also in the case of JBB CHF, they are expected to gain the levels after making the extreme moves. So that's what they are expected to do in the case of the European crisis. Because the European crisis is a less number when compared to the Asian crisis. So we'll find that swing and slide today during the Japanese and European session, and swing and permit during the US session. Then tomorrow we are expected to make the swings during the Japanese session, creating the uncertainty, and slowly permit swing and permit during the European session, engaging the sharp sellers to do the sharp covering, and later on they will try to make a slide. Then we will try to make a dip and hit the stops. This is the normal strategy. Whenever they want to drop the market, they just dip and come up, and it will appear the dips are buy opportunities. And afterwards, they will swing and rise during the European session. And later on, they will try to swing and slide again and down and go below the earlier low set. Then afterwards, 12th Thursday, swing and come up. Will be seen during the Japanese session, and then swing and drop during the European session, and swing and come up under the drop level to be seen during the US session. Then on Friday, they will try to make the swing and drop, visible drop, then slowly come up from there, and then dip again to create the feel that they are going to reverse it, but quickly they will drop from the mid-year session on Friday. So then we will understand that the players are here to bring the trend reversal moves. And when all find that after the US month of payroll data, and when people expected even GDP drop, they just gained it. So this is how we make the moves of the market. We need to understand. And the third is find that, okay, fundamentally use the straight clear indication of the market to drop. They just pretend as if it is going to drop, but they try to gain back, telling some of the story that there won't be any quantity easing in this sort of thing. So ultimately, you will find the tapering of the quantity easing. So you will find that when the traders expect some more, the players make against them. And it is not the simple expectations, so the traders need to commit positions. Normally what happens when the traders commit positions after the drop, the sell position, when the non-farm payroll is extremely good, then immediately they gain to the level, induce them to do the short covering. And if they want, they can continue to rise. If they want, they can continue to rise, and nobody is there to stop them. But they are not doing it. So ultimately, why they gain? In order to put the stops on the short sellers, and also induce them to do the short covering for weekend. And once the weekend comes, the players develop, the traders develop the uncertainty. And the traders do not normally carry forward the positions to about the next week. Invariably, the platform charge overnight interest, and also the traders develop the fear that suddenly the market opens with an upward gap, then there might be a margin fall. So they just do the short covering. When they have been holding at higher level, the psychological level of 1.37 in the case of euro. And GBP will gain the levels quickly and then make the drop in order to gain the levels in the case of euro GBP. That is what they believe is a pump and dump move, and in the process, euro GBP went up and hit all the stops on the higher side. So again today, they will try to make the upward stopping. In the case of euro, they already done it, and in the case of GBP also. And here, the end, they are trying to hold it, probably they may take out the stops above the 1.103 and start making the slide. Then you will find USD CHF gaining considerably. Last week, you noticed that USD CHF was holding slowly, sliding, that sort of news, and they will try to reverse it. And in the case of Canadian dollar, last just made up and down move, and either way stops. And this week they are expected to make initially the contrarian move, come across, here's the cat and here's Australian dollar showing positive net change. So they are trying to handle the commodity crisis, and later on we'll find that there's the cat coming down. And Australian dollar is also coming down as a contrarian move before making the next price. And as he is expected to drop only nominally, not like that of your own GDP. So the expected market moves are shown, and next week that will be the third week of the yearly trend reversal time, 16th to 20th of December. Again, the volatile moves are expected to continue, and they are expected to prepare for the year-end move. So the year-end move, normally they make an extended upward stopping or an extended downward stopping, and then reverse for the new year. So this time they are expected to make an upward extended stopping. Before that, they will try to accumulate the buy positions after making the drop. And the traders think that it is going to be a quick fall, similar to last month end, how they have done it. And this time they will just make a drop and then stop gaining quickly the levels. And probably in a week, they will be able to make two extreme moves, one on the downside, one on the upside for the and you know that there will be Christmas holidays, etc. In spite of that, it will come across. The players try to make the moves during the third week, and the last week they will try to improve the information. They will try to bring in the levels to just show, just to prepare themselves for the next move. Now, we will go to the expected ranges. You can set the low as 1.32 and 1.3750 could be the high. So far they are showing 1.3720 and the low is 1.3702. They expect you to make a slide. Then GBP from 6375 area, they are showing so far 6352 and they could they can come up to the 63.22 and they are expected to make for the slack. And if it is of the end, 103.50 could be the high and 100.50 could be the low. They will try to bring in the contrarian in all the three pairs and drop the end process while handling the majors and also the commodity European process. Then in the case of CHM, they just come down extremely from the 90 area to 89 area, and 89.10, they are just accumulated. Now they are indicating that they want to make an upward move because of US CHM. So downward move is very limited in the case of US with CHM, and they are expected to go in the 11th to come here. Already they are just increasing the initial low by 2 pips because of US with CHM. Then Canadian dollar. After rising to 1.07 area, they could make an upward stopping and so far they are showing 1.0660 and they are expected to come down to 1.05 area. Then Australian dollar, it could come down to 0.90 area and then upside it could show 0.90 area and it will be range bound and so the drugs you can buy. And what they do is, you know, the commodity guys lead the rally and lag behind. And you will notice from last month, they have been continuously dropping Australian dollar, but when Euro GBP started dropping, as he was holding. Now again, they will try to make no drop in the case of Euro GBP, but less drop in the case of Aussie. And Aussie will be the first plan to just make the reversal more on the upside, as they will be handling the commodity crash. Commodity prices in the commodities later on come to the other benches. So that is how the expected moves are and the range. Now coming to about the market reading. So we move down the initial highs and the lows around 3:32 and 2 majors of 2 commodity prices. And the reason is the reference level for the day. They identify the type and sequence of market moves they make in subsequent sessions. So here are the initial layers of the hives. Now we will compare the method with the current, with the initial layers in the hives set around 3:30 GMT. Now this spikes at 3 GMT. So here I found the low 1.3702, high was 1.3720, such a narrow consolidation is happening. It was slightly improved in the case of GBV, 1.6324 is the low, 1.6354 is the high, but still, they are just only making the swings between these two. And in the case of EMU, another 2.89, and the downside has become the low, whereas the high is not that. So they intended to make the drop in the case of USD, and so they are already compelled there, and then turn that another big drop for the down. Stage of 0.8910 is the low, 0.8926 was the initial low, initial high, they just placed it and found the rate. So these are the indications that they wanted to make an upward move in the case of USDCH. And Canadian dollar, 1.064 is the low, 1.060 is the high, so they are just oscillating in a narrow range. And Aussie, 0.9097 is the low, 0.9130 is the high. Again, they are just consolidating with 33 pips, and they are expected 37 pips, and they are expected to make further download more in the case of Aussie, and it will be limited, not a big drop. And as they are expected to make it in the case of Euro and Shibu. So, with regard to the trading strategy, so after doing the market trading, we try to find out whether the market is near the high or the low. During the day, early or the late sessions, then we are trying to trade, focus on the matches. When we are trying to focus on the prices, we just look for the mid sessions and take the positions. When they stop breaching the new high or new low for more than 30 minutes, near the high we take a sell, and near the low we take a buy, but still, if 30 pips still over, we limit the risk. Once the position makes profit, at 25 pips, we keep stop at entry so that we'll be able to eliminate the risk. And then, subsequently, when the move is good, we train the stop 15 pips away from the market and try to close the position. And thereby, we'll be able to retake the profit, what we have seen. And for the take profit level, we can keep 45 or 74 limit order. And if the market either hit the trailing stop or the take profit order, we'll see that the position is closed. So we should not repent when they hit our trailing stop. And we should not think that, oh, I could have just avoided that, thereby they would have hit my limit. But if you develop a mindset like that and stop keeping, not keeping the stop at entry or simply holding the hedge order, then you quickly reverse and hit your pitch. Then the opportunity is missed. Then again, you have to redo the regarding of all the best positions. So instead, in a market when it is undergoing the yearly trend reverses, try to book profit as being trades profit. So, it is advisable to do swing trades rather than position trade during this particular time frame. Now, for that, my important information will be that focus on the session timings and also the early, mid, and the late sessions timings. Thereby, we'll be able to easily identify how we are shifting from one pair to another pair during this particular time frame. So that the session timings will indicate when exactly they are going to handle the majors during early in the mid sessions, early in the late sessions, and mid sessions to handle the costs. And as I explained many times, they handle only two currencies at a time. And also you find that now a currency which has made more than 20 pips, they are trying to handle it. So now Aussie and Yen, one will be around 25 to 30 pips, but the rest of the pins here again GDP. So they are making very slow moves at the moment. And slowly we find some currencies making 30 pips, that means spread between the high and the low, and then such currencies are being handled. So So depending upon the increase in the volume number of the traders, that is when traders commit new positions, then the players start making the moves. Otherwise they simply go into the market. And even if the traders allow to commit in position, they bring in the volatility before the data release. So that the trader will try and develop the tense condition like non-temporary, and then the traders look for the opportunity. When the data is fundamental data is good for US dollar, then the traders try to take sell position. By the time the market would have moved down, then they immediately take sell position. Sometimes they wait for a small pullback and take sell positions. And later on, the players make big move upside and shoot the stops. So it is not 100% true or 100% perfect following the technicals or fundamental goods, because the players make the moves depending upon the traders' committed positions. When all the traders turn long, when the players don't rise, even if the data is very positive to euro or chip, still they don't rise, instead slowly, and from the data they don't make much of a reaction, and immediately people will say that it has been already discounted or factored in to that of the pricing. But slowly you will find that market slide, because that indicates that the traders are turned long. And when they will get in reversal time, holding time will find what the traders are doing. And afterwards, if traders still continue to short, then they may make an upward stop and even make an upward. So ultimately, they see that the traders don't easily make money, because the players wanted to make all the profit for their investments. Now, this is the early trend reversal time. Once again, I caution you that the last month of the year and the first week of the year, till January 2015, we will continue to see the early trend reversal move. That is the mid extreme moves, game levels. And then suddenly start dropping. And you know, when they make the drop, it takes lesser time. But gaining takes more time. In any market for that matter, gaining, they have to pump in more money and then try to gain the levels. But in a dropping market, it is very easy for them. They don't lend the support, they simply take two sell positions and they don't keep any buy orders, and the traders also keep buy orders. Automatically, the next buy will be hit, the market drops very fast. So, unless you find the gains takes a longer time, the drops takes a few days. And even in multi-year trend reversals in 2008, well, the gain, they took nearly about 9 months, but the drop happened in a matter of about 15 days. So, understand the magnitude of the market and avoid getting margin calls by developing the market sentiments. So, if it become bullish or bearish, and the players are here going to attack you, then join with the head of the traders and try to use your common sense. You'll be able to really make money of that. Now, I'll take up the questions which are asked here. In charge, how to identify that changes are in a near high or low? Is that by watching them exchange? If you have missed around 3:30 GMT, the next is watch around 8 GMT. And in the time of the third change, see, why we don't make our eyes up out of the heart? If all traders turn around, then they do not want to go profit for them. And they will bother about the stocks above, because predominantly the traders are long. So, based on the sentiment created, so they try to avoid making an upper stop and straight make the slide. If the traders are short here, then they make a small stop if needed. The stops are quite far away, then they make an extended move on the upside before making a profit. So, we need to identify the type of moves. Then we will be able to understand what they are trying to do. Always during the start of the session, late session, they will try to make the stop, as I explained. So, wait for the late session and then try to see what they are playing with. So from time to time we have to watch it, because time to time they come to know whether the traders are long or short. Because when they make one upper stop and then drop, many of the stops will have been hit, and the traders might try to take the long positions. Then there is no need for them to make an upper stop. So no statistics will be able to estimate exactly what is going to be the high. We have to watch it in the long market, where the stocks are held, then accordingly they try to make the moves. If there are only 10 stocks on the higher side and there are already 90 traders holding long positions, then why they should do the stop and just to make a small penny out of this stop and if they make an upper stop, then those who are taking the long position can exit. It might be a scalper also. The scalping people will try to exit out of the position with a small profit. Or a breakout trader will play in for a small profit. So they should avoid giving profit for such traders. So what in the world is a hidden agenda for the players, but they don't reveal us whether the traders are net long or net short, and the platforms provide just varied information scattering to their clients, etc. But ultimately the true picture will be known based on the type of news they create. Today I'm going to extreme high. Yes. That's how we do it, as I told you. And can we expect to drop this week? Yes, it is expected to drop in a big way as well. See, in regard to the range, it all depends upon the traders taking positions as I explained. And when the traders, after the drop, try to take a bad position, then they will make further drop. But after the drop, if the traders say, it has gone up nearly about 700 pips, so another 100 pips drop might be possible if they try to say, when the players make a new high in the stocks. That is how the game is. So we need to read it, and as I say every time, don't simply depend upon the forecast. We also don't depend upon the support and the resistance. You use your trading strategy to limit the risk. And there is no point in telling that the market has moved as per the expectations or it has respected my forecast, etc. Ultimately, how we are able to earn money from the market is about, and that is important for us. The EME, or the GB, the CHF, and the USD, the CHF correlated. They are correlated because CHF moves and GB moves are correlated to that of the cross GB, the CHF. Which one is better to play? See, it all depends upon your equity. And if you are trying to trade it in cross, we need more equity because the spread is more. And in the case of the majors, you find volatility. But in the case of crosses, you come across your inside of moves. So if you are against the trend, then you should use necessarily a hedging to limit the risk. If you don't have the hedging facility, and if they continue to drop slowly, because if they drop GBV as soon as you use the CHF, they will find the GBV CHF will make a double edge effect or more drop. So you should be able to withstand it. So don't simply commit positions just because they look attractive. Also look into your equity, whether it will be able to withstand such moves in the market, especially during the yearly trend reversals. So my suggestion, if your equity is more than $30,000, then you can take mini loss in USD CHF or GBP CHF. If equity is less than that, focus only on majors, because they will try to bring in the volatile news. At least you will be able to earn money. If not a big profit, a small profit at least, because they bring in the volatility here in these three currencies. And the amounts of times they make one side of move. Most preferable currency could be euro and GBP. There, they necessarily bring in the volatility in order to handle the rest of the currencies and also to create the market sentiments. So, end of the question, so that I'll be willing to answer the questions, otherwise I'll wind up the webinar. can show the last slide. So I take this opportunity to thank Dr. Sridhar for bringing my weekly webinar, giving the expected market news for the week. And I will be able to present it on Thursday because of certain commitments. So I'll come back on the 16th of December, the next Monday, and do the podcast for the following week. Then afterwards, you come across 16th December, and afterwards, you come across the market close for the Christmas mode and things like that here and more. And so I don't know how FX Trade is going to schedule the webinars. So try to look into the webinar schedules in FX Trade from time to time from now on, and see what are the days they are giving the webinars and the thing. Accordingly, I'll be presenting the expected market news and also do the analysis of the market. So my recorded webinar will be posted in onlineindices.com/blog and also FXTrade.net. Then you can come up with it from time to time and find out whether the market is moving, find out whether the expectations are against. So my humble suggestion will be, use the hedging order, if not stop, to limit the risk. Forecast is a forecast which can come true or it can go against the expectations. The market can go against the expectations. So thank you, Mumbai. Wish you all very happy trading. And so that you take only minimum positions, not over trading. So that you'll be able to survive during this particular PLA trend reversal pattern. Thank you. See you next week.